He's a dangerous customer, Ichiro Suzuki.
I think he's the only big league player with his first name on his back. Goes by Ichiro, not Suzuki. Kind of like Elvis.
From what I understand, Suzuki is like Smith in Japan. That's a very, very common name. So maybe to distinguish himself, he went with Ichiro.
And Ichiro means first son. And unfortunately, though, he was the second son born to the family.
He definitely is. I mean, if you are not a Seattle fan, he's the guy that you go to the ballpark when you're, you know, in Seattle for a night that you go to see. Good all-around athlete that became a great baseball player.
2-2. Driven out into left center field. Melky Cabrera on the run, going back, still back. It's over his head and goes up against the wall. Two-run score, and Ichiro stops at second.
And one of the first things when he came up, they said Ichiro meant first son, and yet he was the second boy in the family. However, in checking the Japanese characters, there's one that's different that changes it. So his name means brightest, most cheerful. Suzuki, when Japan was almost decimated by the earthquake and tsunami, he donated $1,250,000. And he wails away for a base hit. The amazing Ichiro. It's magic the way he swings that bat and just strokes it into left field.
Not going to be in time. That one bloop, not very deep. O'Neill has got a chance at the plate. Cameron tags and will have to stay there.
He stayed there for one reason. Because number 51 stepping into the batter's box here with just one out. Cameron's got great speed. You're going to test that arm in any other situation except this one with Ichiro. I'm wondering if they want to take a chance on Ichiro. This guy has changed the game of baseball now. I'm telling you, they wondered when he came to spring training, well, what's going to happen? You know, is he the real thing? We know he was good over in Japan. What about here? This is big league baseball. Well, that's a big league talent that you're looking at on your screen now.
Do you walk him?
Do I? Heck yeah.
One down, runners at second and third, and that's what they're going to do. Guy who had the best batting average in these situations in baseball during the regular season. Left-handed pitcher, left-handed batter. You figure the Yankees got the advantage. Still doesn't matter. 10 intentional walks this year. McLemore will come up with the bases loaded.
How can you walk a rookie, huh? Well, it's a little different story here with this rookie. Obviously the rookie of the year, in my opinion, the MVP of the year. Most of the time it was Ichiro that did that position, and we've got the best hitter in the American League at hitting with runners in scoring position coming to home plate.
Ichiro Suzuki, who hit an eye-popping 445 with runners in scoring position.
They're not going to let him hit.
They're going to walk in with first base open. So the crowd airs out its collective lungs here in the direction of Mendoza and Joe Torre.
Ramirez in center. So they will intentionally pass Ichiro to get to Willie Bloomquist.
How about Ichiro Suzuki? How many times now has he been intentionally walked?
It's 27.
27th time this year.
Gosh. Most in the American League.
For a leadoff hitter.
What became a three-run first inning, the biggest first inning of the year, they put him on. Ichiro, no stranger to intentional walks with Mike Socia down back in Southern California for the graduation, high school graduation of one of his daughters. Mike's going to pick up the team. They go to Oakland, which is their next stop.
Into the right field corner and got an infield hit, and they're going to put him on. Not a surprise. So Ichiro
Here in the major leagues, combined with his time in Japan. They want that baseball. A nice moment. The crowd made.
Hall of Fame was here in their locker room before this game. It was down there. They're going to take the bat. They're going to take the ball. Tell you what, that's a great moment.
So 2,500 hits for Suzuki and for Hudson. I don't know if there are 500 hits left on that resume. I don't think it will matter with regard to Cooperstown. For me, and I'd love to know your thoughts, this is the first ballot Hall of Famer.
Well, I agree. I think he changed the game. I think Ida brought a whole different style to the game. He does all the things that hitting coaches tell hitters not to do. Drifts, hits on his front foot, lets the ball get too deep. Well, what a career.
And that pitch is golfed into right field for a base hit, a line drive. Got a familiar sight.
And the way that his weight distributes, how does he do this as a hitter? I mean, his hands never seem to move.
Well, that's exactly it. As you see that sight profile of him taking that swing, although he does have.
Watch him take batting practice, and then when he decides I'm going to hit some home runs at BP, wow, listen, he could put a show on.
I'm going to tell you something. He could win the home run derby at the All-Star break. He can do it. And he's been invited, but he refuses, so almost got picked off there.
You know, you've got a pair of Ichiros there. And they say that imitation is the sincerest form of flattery. And
yeah, but they weren't all geared up like this. I mean, this guy's got on the elbow pad and everything.
He's got the same sideburns, too.
Yeah. It's borderline creepy.
Look, I think this is the same guy. Last year, he was actually signing autographs for kids who thought he was Ichiro. Ichiro to left field, a base hit. How about that? 25 away. Now, the numbers that they've got up are the hits towards the Pete Rose total. They're going Pete Rose total. How about that? 25 away for Ichiro.
Okay, his buddy's killing me now. He just took off the elbow pad at the same time Ichiro took off his elbow pad.
Although, you know what? I think if Ichiro got to start his career in the major leagues, I think he would be past Rose at this point. Because remember, in Japan, his first 9 years in Japan, they play only 100. This guy's creeping me out.
I told you. Watch. Dude, he gets the same lead. Watch this. Dude, I'm telling you, this is beyond a little creepy right here. Like, this is.
Anyways, first 9 years. In Japan, they only play 142, 144 games. And obviously, Rose came in right when the schedule had changed to 162. Prado muscles up. Left field deep. Upton back. At the wall. Gone.
Yes, he is. And he's now going to take his lead as Ichiro does at first base. He needs an aisle to be able to do this.
That's hilarious.
He's really into it. I would say he's a really big Ichiro Suzuki fan. I wonder if Ichiro goes, if he goes, running down the aisle.
Does he slide?
Ichiro slides? I don't know. Does he slide? He must. He does everything that Ichiro does. That makes his way to second base. Now that was kind of a shortened run to second base, but he even goes to the gloves.
Did you see he's even loosening the gloves like him?
Yes. Ichiro was on base when Prado hit the home run. This is the way this fan reacted to it. And there goes the home run. So now he can just jog. Ichiro runs. Now he's going to do a little bit of running to get around all the bases. He's going to run some stairs. This is something. He's not taking pictures with people.
That guy finished the marathon.
Not only is he on second base getting the lead, but he's also taking pictures with people.
He's going to need security. Did you see that?
Julian, meet the other Ichiro.
Oh, wait a second. It's not Ichiro? I thought he came out of the game just to talk to me. Oh, well, apparently it's not. This is Yutaro. He is a local super fan of Ichiro. That it took you 5 years to perfect the Ichiro impersonation. What is the key to the perfect Ichiro impersonation?
Well, やっぱり僕の一番好きなのがイチローのパフォーマンスですね。もうこのような。もうこのイチローのポーズですね。やっぱりこういうところは絶対あの忘れてはならないだろうし、まあ、これからもずっと受け継がれていくんじゃないかなと思います。
Very, very cool. He also brought his friends who are wearing Ichiro jerseys as well and keeping track of the hit count. Thank you so much. Arigato. Back to you guys.
All right. Thank you very much, Julie. How about that?
Very cool.
Very cool. This is driven out towards deep right center field. Back goes Ozuna, and on the run is Ichiro to make the catch. Good long running catch.
Watch Ichiro in right field, and what really makes you a really good outfield, that flash look. Watch him peek at the center fielder and realizes he has to go get it. Ozuna is too far away from that. As we see the impersonation keep on going.
It's no longer in the aisle, it looks like. Julie interviewed him earlier. One thing I wondered about is whether or not he's ever had the chance to meet Ichiro in person. Chance to meet him, or maybe it's a dangerous situation. Maybe they should not have him meet him.
Very similar to the real Ichiro. So my first question for you, when did you begin impersonating Ichiro? Have you ever met Ichiro?
Actually, yeah, Japanese restaurant in America. But
he saw him once in our Japanese restaurant, the Yakiniku Prince. Oh, nice! Okay. You got to meet him in a restaurant. What was that interaction?
Maybe secret. Yeah. He chose that. Maybe angry. So, yeah. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. Ichiro-san. Sorry.
All right, well, thank you so much for spending some time with us. Guys, back to you.
He's got a sense of humor, this guy, doesn't he?
I guarantee you he ordered the same thing when he went to the restaurant with Ichiro.
Ichiro, base hit down the third baseline. He's got three hits tonight.
Where am I, Ichiro?
Unbelievable. 23 away from 3,000. He is one shy of Rose's mark.
Because they're spread over two leagues, is he in the class with Pete Rose?
Well, I'll take it. I love what he's able to do. I believe he's a Hall of Famer, definitely, and I think he'll go down as one of the best. But to put him in Pete Rose category and Ty Cobb, that's kind of making a stretch.
You're saying that Ichiro, he's still a great hitter. He's the same kind of hitter. I think he's a better hitter than Pete Rose, actually. I do think that. And I've been around him for years.
We don't even need to bring his statistics from Japan in.
That's good.
Right.
Pete Rose had 10 200 hit seasons in 24 years.
Yes.
Ichiro had 200 hit seasons in 10 straight years. He's a better.
You're talking about
10.
Two different eras.
It doesn't matter.
Ichiro
is a better.
He's still hitting balls.
It's not a better baseball. He's a better fielder, yes, maybe. But you're talking about a person who's transcended the game. Yes, unfortunately, he was with a bad team in Seattle. Now, you talk about what he's been able to
do. He wasn't really with a bad team.
Pete Rose was able to lead his team to win a championship, let alone over 750 doubles in his career?
Well, Ichiro is doing the same thing. He's doing the same thing. He's doing the same thing.
I'm talking about American baseball, and you want to bring the Japan.
We're not bringing that in.
Let me ask you a question. So you're holding that against him?
I'm not holding it against him, but when it comes to American baseball, just like football, mm-hmm. you don't bring what you did in Canadian League over to what you did in
the football. He doesn't need to.
Pete Rose's 10 best seasons and put him up against Ichiro seasons in 2001 to 2011, I looked it up and I was shocked at what I saw.
Well, that's good you're shocked.
Well, be shocked. Let me shock you again.
The years are different.
Let me shock you. Yeah, you should be.
56 steals. His highest average is 372.
You're from Seattle, so of course.
He holds the major league record for hits in a season at 262. If he had played here, he would be threatening Pete Rose's.
Yes, he would.
If he had played here, who knows if he would have got hurt there while he played.
When he did, that's all they're saying. Versus zero gold gloves. He's a better all-around player than Pete Rose.
Great job, guys. But I won. Thank you.
Ichiro, in just your eighth Major League Baseball game, you made one of the throws of the decade to nail Terrence Long from right field.
Terrence Long, the throw by Ichiro. Beautiful. Peggy got him.
How did you do it? Why did he run when I was going to throw him out? Ichiro, what's your dog's name? I don't have my dog's permission to tell you that. Ichiro, what will you do once you retire? I don't know. I guess I'll die. There's something I find really inspiring about Ichiro's friendly, matter-of-fact stubbornness. You can see it in his words and in his play. None of this was supposed to work. None of it was supposed to carry over from Japan. But Ichiro knew it would. And he wasn't going to change a damn thing about the way he played baseball. Analyst and former player Rob Dibble declared at the start of the season that if Ichiro won the batting title, he'd get an Ichiro tattoo on his butt and run around Times Square in a G-string. That season, Ichiro hit 350 and won the batting title, the Rookie of the Year Award, the MVP Award, a Silver Slugger, and a Gold Glove. Thanks for playing, Rob.
We're teammates with the Seattle Mariners. We go down to Tampa Bay to play. And he is very protective, overprotective of his bats. Keeps them in a humidor. Keeps everyone accountable for. I mean, they're like his precious collection. And I was struggling. And I said, Ichiro, can I use your bat for the game? He's like, come on. And he said, Ichiro, come on, let me use your bat. And it's the first time that I played in Japan, because culturally, it's very difficult for the Japanese culture to say no. So I was in shock when Ichiro told me straight out, no. I said, well, come on. Well, he looked the other way, and I ended up taking one of his bats because I was struggling. I was desperate. And right when I'm going up to the plate, I call over, and I say, Ichiro. And I show him that I'm using his bat, and he was so mad. And I get up in there, I choke up on the bat, which is already a small bat, but that's the way I used to hit. And I proceeded to hit one off the end of the bat, a seeing eye single. And I got to first, and I was so happy, and he's looking at me, just waving off, saying, that's it, you keep the bat. Oh, he was so disappointed in me, but I was so happy, I didn't care. And I gave him all the hugs and love possible, and he ended up signing the bat for me.
Did you use it again? Bags loaded here. A smash by Prado into left. Neuenheis scores. Walsh around third. Throws a good one. And Ichiro can still get it done in left field.
Why did they send him?
Not sure.
Not as strong as it used to be, but very accurate. And able to get Walsh at home plate. Still can't run on him.
Yep. After all these years.
A bullet by Maldonado, his first hit of the season, and I think Colin Walsh was a little surprised that Eddie sent him. Kind of slowed down a little bit, then good tag by Real Muto, and a good throw by Suzuki. One hopper right on the money. Doesn't get any better than that.
Done a heck of a job this year in about every capacity. Ichiro falls down. Off the top, wouldn't that have been something? He hurts himself. He almost went back into the stands. Wouldn't that have been something to hurt himself? Oh my gosh.
Look at it again. He's going to run up, get on top of the stands like that, and then all of a sudden coming down. Look at this. Ichiro. You don't have to go to the fifth or sixth row to catch a ball. Easy, pal.
Our results on our poll about how many hits Ichiro is going to have when it's all over.
50% of them saying somewhere between 259, 260, and 261, right in the middle there. And tune in tomorrow's pregame show to see if you're a winner of an Edgar Martinez autographed baseball. Now Shao set. Here comes the 2-2 to Ichiro on the way. Swung on, line drive, base hit center field. There's number 262. My, oh my, what a way to cap off an unbelievable year. And there is our Magnolia moment. A standing ovation, Ichiro acknowledging it, taking his batting helmet off down there.